hear the crows. Death is like a blessing, a true release. Imprisoning their black, dark souls.
Lord of mercy upon my soul.
The judge has decided to pardon me.
I am talking about his soul!
It's time to cut the bond.
It's gonna go nowhere.
Nobody gave you the permission to talk!
Okay, I'm here with the great Domiziano Arcangeli for more horror.
Hello, thank you, Dawna.
So what brings you to this event tonight?
Oh, I'm here actually to present the brand new trailer of a movie I'm starring in, along with the great Tiffany Shepis, Debbie Rochon, Tara Cardinal, Brian Fortune from Game of Thrones, Matteo Tosi, Michael Siegel, a lot of great, great actors. The movie was shot in Italy, and it's actually somewhat of a new event, and that's really pretty much the theme of this night. It's a co-production between Italian and the United States. So we shot in beautiful Italy in the most gorgeous countryside.
How did that happen? Why did he decide to shoot in Italy and make it in English?
Well, because that's his background. He basically, Ivan Zuccon is an Italian filmmaker that is getting major recognition from Italy. But I must say, more than anywhere else, from the international markets. In fact, his films sell all over the world, and he started with a smaller budget films shot in English, and this little budget horror was sold, I think, in 29 countries. So yeah. Film after film, he got more money for the budgets, mm-hmm. and he made another movie with Tiffany Shepis three, four years ago, and then another one, Colors of the Dark, that did very well on DVD and Blu-ray here, mm-hmm. just 2 or 3 years ago. And now, he raised a bigger budget, mm-hmm. and he made this Wrath of the Crows, which has already a major Italian and European distribution, and we're working to help him to find the best distribution for the United States as well. But, it's great that his films are appreciated in so many different countries.
So,
and that's why he shoots in English, because obviously, mm-hmm. English is somewhat of the world language, the international language for markets. And he has as a backdrop this wonderful locations that he can find in Italy. In fact, particularly the one we shot was mainly shot nearby the River Po, which is a huge river in Italy that crosses the old country. Mm-hmm. And there are beautiful, beautiful countrysides and beautiful sceneries around that. And also on the lakes area, like Lake Garda and Adria, Rovigo, near Bologna. Mm-hmm. Bologna, it's the famous place where Bologna was invented.
Okay, now this is a bigger budget movie.
Yes.
So
yes,
is this like his biggest?
Is biggest to date, definitely, and also it was shot mainstream to aim really to a wider audiences. And again, it's done well even with smaller movies. So we really have great expectations for this one.
Well, the trailer's really exciting. And I heard you talk in there about how the marketing was geared towards the more sensationalistic aspects, but that it's really a psychological horror?
Yes, that's my opinion anyway. I think, you know, obviously he's really, he has a huge fan base from Fangoria especially, and you know, as a horror film director. So I think this trailer focused more on the, you know, like someone was a little shocked by this violent images, but
doesn't someone get something in the forehead? I mean, I was a little shocked.
I know. Well, and you yeah, there are definitely very, very shocking moments. Also, for my character, and it was hard on set too. I mean, I was all. And I'll just say that, Ivan, don't hate me, but you know, I'll just say all that. I was tied up on barbed wire, real barbed wire, for a few hours to make this scene, you know. So and I had a crane coming down on me, and up and down, and up and down. They were great, though. He works, is a professional, is a joy to work with, is technically so well prepared. And what's wonderful is that his whole family works in the movies. He's also well known in Italy. Has been well known for a long time as the editor of Pupi Avati, which is Italian number one director and producer right now, and has been for a while. Yes, this movie, you know, are often up to Academy Awards nominations for foreign language. And so in his family, you know, everybody was working in this movie, you know, because they have all this great passion, and they believe in their son so much, and it was so inspiring and endearing. And
does Yvonne live there, or still, or where is he based now?
Oh, he's based, he doesn't even live in Rome, which is where, you know, the main studios in Italy are. No, he keeps in Rovigo, which is this little town near, in the north of Italy, nearby the Po River, and between Venice, you know, and where I was born, by the way. And so I was, you know.
I didn't know really that. You were born in Venice?
Oh,
what is...
No,
it's well, not. Speaking of that, let's make a little detour. How are your sons?
Oh, my sons are great. Skylar and Thor are doing fantastic. They have 3 months, and sometimes I think they must be 7 or 8 months. I mean, really, they're learning so much every day, and I'm so excited to see them growing so healthy and so happy, and you know, they're twins, but they're fraternal twins, so
yeah.
They're not similar at all. You know, Thor is actually really, it's funny because everybody's saying, you know, that I found the right name for him because it's like really big and blonde and really white, you know, and just it looks like really a long kid, and just
he looks like Thor then.
He looks like Thor, you know, the character. While Skylar is more introspective, he has big, big blue eyes, and he always looks at the sky, you know, he stares at the sky. He's very poetic. And, you know, so it's two different personas, and at the same time so connected and alive. You know, my life has changed forever. I mean, of course, I love making movies still, but I must say, it makes it a little hard to want to go to work sometimes.
I have to say, it agrees with you. You look great.
Thank you.
And
you,
their mom is a model, right? Or a supermodel, or used to be?
The
twins?
Oh, yes. Yes, the mother.
I read that.
Yeah, no, I thought you were saying my mom. The mother of the twins, yeah. She's of Swedish and Scottish heritage, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, then that's why Thor is Thor. Right?
Yes, exactly. But, you know, it's interesting because they both, at least people tell me, that they both see so much of me in them. Definitely Thor has the colors of his mother, and probably also the huge physique because she's really tall. And Skylar maybe is more, I don't know, but anyways, they're just, you know, gorgeous. And
yeah, Skylar sounds very sensitive and creative.
Very, yeah. I think I think I see an artist there somehow already, but I sense them anyways, but I'm not 100% sure. Obviously, they're 3 months. Come on.
Still a handful with twins, though, and it's amazing that you can balance it out and work as much as you do.
Yeah, I've been managing. You know, it's such a happy time. You know, they tell me I'm sleeping too little, and I think they're right. I'm not sleeping enough.
What are you doing with the parrots?
Oh, the parrots are actually well behaved. They're really sweet. You know, they just like keep on their own cages. And believe it or not, the older parrot, the female, the cockatoo, she's so fond of my sons. I mean, she's crazy for them. She's really like, she feels like she's really family. And she's got like this little smile. Friends come over and they take her, you know, close to the kids, and she just loves to stare at them. It's really nice. I'm blessed to have these two wonderful kids, but also my wonderful pets. I love mm-hmm. them so much. You know,
and
my
parents. A beautiful house, and a bunch of great movies coming out. So you're representing Wrath of Crows tonight.
Yes, because Ivan Zucon is very busy in Italy editing this, you know, this movie that will be ready for fall 2012, but also is editing Pupi Avati, this other very famous director film, because their bond is so strong. So he's really busy with that as well. So he asked me to come here to present on his behalf this new trailer. Uh-huh. Like I was saying, you know, it's his choice of marketing. I think the movie is more of a psychological story, and some of the audience was a little shocked, but I told them, I had to tell them that the movie has a lot more, you know, and mm-hmm.
Every movie
fantastic.
Oh, know? It did look fantastic in every movie that you're in. You bring like an inner spirit anyway.
Yes, and you know, and you know, before the movie will come out, who knows how many other trailers there will be. There is still time, so this is the first one, and mm-hmm. and definitely gives an idea. But you know, it's also nice, I think, to let it to be a surprise. You know, to expect,
yes.
you know, something, and then to find a lot more. I think it's more interesting not to give it all away. So.
And what a perfect place to premiere it too.
Yes, this house, this beautiful house, we're really lucky, and I had this huge surprise, you know, to learn that the host, because I was told it was Villa Francesca in Malibu, mm-hmm. and Francesca is the wife of a very famous actor, Richard Harrison, who made tons and tons of movies back in the 60s and 70s, and is here tonight as a great host. He doesn't really want to talk too much about his past as an actor, but he is, you know, he's done so many, and it's fun. It's fun because, you know, I was just a child starting back then, and I think he was about actually to retire after many years of work. But, you know, we know a lot of the same people. So, you know, we have probably worked with more than a couple of directors. And, and maybe, you know, we could have even worked together. Who knows? Just, you know, it's just really, really fun.
So his wife is Francesca then.
Lovely, lovely lady. Oh, yes. So nice.
There's a picture of her up here.
Yes.
Well, he still looks great then, because I just saw him over there.
Absolutely.
But, oh my gosh, Domi, that's amazing.
You know, like a very good looking leading man. So.
Well, he still is, yeah.
He still is like gracious host and a very classy man, definitely. I
mean. So what a wonderful place to premiere Wrath of Crows.
Wonderful, also because, again, it all makes sense. It comes mm-hmm. together. You know, this bridge, Italy meets Hollywood again. Let's try to make co-productions. And
yeah, I know you're the CEO of Empire Films. Seems like you're very connected to Italy. I know that you were born in Venice, you told me tonight,
yes.
But your mother is American.
But yes.
And you did your first film at 12, right?
Yes. I was
with Fellini?
No. Well, he found out about me and he introduced me to the screen. Then I to say the, you know, the right tell the story straight. I worked with him later on, like 6 or 7 years later. But the first film was with a director who used to be a friend of Federico Fellini, and it was at his first feature. It was one of his famous assistants and writers and co-writers, and so Fellini saw me on the cover of some magazine from a picture that had been taken by the famous photographer Helmut Newton, who was really the first one who really found me. And these pictures were really famous also because, you know, I was so young, but I
already, and it's beautiful.
Thank you. I had a little bit of, you know, I was still a child, but I had a little bit of malice in my eyes. And this was like a little bit disconcerting at the time. And so Fellini and many other directors, I must say, noticed those pictures. And in a way, that's how I started to act. He called me in Rome and he had me to audition for this movie, which was called Eden No Sono. It was a romantic drama with very famous Italian stars of the time, and still very well known anyways, and they needed a 12 years old, and I started with that one, and then from movie to movie. And then in 1987, when I was a little older, I was on the set of Intervista with Fellini himself, finally. And he gave me two paintings, you know, because after the movie I worked on set. It was such a long shoot, months and months. He used to do that all the time anyways, and that's why his films are so well known, I guess, because, you know, he took his time. And and he could. He could afford it. We became sort of acquainted, and with his wife also, famous Giulietta Masina, was, you know, the protagonist of La Strada, Academy Award Oscar winning film, and then Juliet of the Spirits, which was, you know, an homage really to his wife, and a great film. And I went to, he had, you know, this office in Via Margutta, which is one of the most beautiful streets in Rome, and he had a few props. He called them props, I call them paintings, that he used on Juliet of the Spirits, this film that was a huge international success in 1965. And I recognized them, and I said, those were the paintings, you know, in Juliet's room, you know? And he said, yeah, you're right. You know, I made them because, you know, the prop artist could keep giving me, you know, these paintings that I couldn't stand. They were awful. So I say, look, give me a couple of nights and I'll make them myself. And so he painted, you know, off of a prop, really, these two beautiful, you know, portraits of India, but sort of an imaginary, you know, sort of like fantastic, you know, India, the India of his oriental dream, let's say, India. And I thought they were fantastic, and, you know, I kept saying it, and it's like, you know, I gotta go now. You know, you just take the pictures, take them home, they're yours. But let me be. I was just a child. I mean, I was a teenager, so, you know, it was just like really a very paternal, you know, father figure almost. And he was really sometimes, you know, he would look very strict and intimidating, of course, but he meant always very well. And I have them now in my house in Los Angeles.
And it's a gorgeous, gorgeous house. Guy, how many people have had a history like you, Domi? I mean,
thank you.
You have so much to tell your sons.
I think I do, and I hope they'll make the best out of it. You know, I hope they'll be their own individuals. I just want to, you know, tell them a lot of fun stories, but then I hope they'll choose what suits them best. And because I believe, you know, in integrity, and everyone is his own person, and everyone should do what is really fond of, you know, what his heart takes him to.
Well, since you're the founder and CEO of Empire Films, if one of your boys wants to be in a film, will you help them? Is that too far down the line? They're 3 months.
It is because, you know, I'm actually always thinking, I hope they won't be involved with the filmmaking. And don't get me wrong, I love filmmaking, obviously, and I don't regret a minute. But I must acknowledge, it is a very tough career, and we all know it.
And you're very protective towards them now.
Yeah, and I feel like, you know, like all parents, I just would like them to be a little more stable. It's not a life that you can call stable all the time.
No, not quite.
Can't be, because we're artists, you know, our minds are all over the place sometimes, especially when we work. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know, you know, if they really want to at some point, of course, I'll encourage them if they really want to, but I won't certainly propose it. No, okay. I will actually try my plan. Well, then we'll see. But my my plan would be just actually to give them a lot of different choices. You know, just like keep them busy with sports, with different languages, with cultures, with a lot of different things, and see what they
piano.
Piano, oh my God, that guy who performed this new composer tonight, Adriano Aponte, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. What a talent.
Yeah.
I had tears almost in my eyes. It was just beautiful music. And anyways, I hope they'll pick really what they feel it's right for them, and not just because they have a father that has been involved since he was a kid. I don't think it's that type of business. You know, you have to be extremely dedicated to make it through all the stuff we go through.
You know, like the barbed wire in Wrath of Crows. I can't wait to see that part.
That's when you get the job. That's when you get the jobs, you know, because a lot of actors, unfortunately, don't even get to do that. I mean, let's face it, it's tough on set, but it's also tough to
get the job,
to book all these jobs. And I mean,
Not tough for you, but, you know, for the average.
It is tough for me, too. Believe me, I'm just lucky sometimes that I'm my own persona, and I bring on the table a certain character. So if I'm right, they'll go in my direction. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong, and, you know, next. You know, I learned at least how to let it go, and, you know, I don't expect it. Sometimes they call me, I didn't even expect it, but it's up to the directors and the producers sometimes to choose. Even in the movies we produce at Empire, I never tell a director, okay, I want to play this part, let's be clear. It never happens like that. I mean, normally we develop projects that I like and that they bring me, also because they know me as an actor, and so they tell me, maybe you could play this part because I had you in mind, but it's never really a plan.
Okay, no. Well, so tonight, Domi's promoting Wrath of Crows, and it's going to be coming out in fall of 2012.
And in the United States a little later, but it's a great movie. It's a stunning story, frightening, with a great twist and a lot of incredible character development and psychological emotions that keep the pace always so intense. I can't wait to see it myself. So bravo, Ivan Zakon, and I'm really, really, really honored to present your movie here tonight.
Okay, thank you, Domi.
Thank you.